Hi, Rosa. I've got to talk to you about the membership listing for the Women's Caucus. There are a few more corrections we have to make in it.
The last 3 years I've been involved with the Chicago Women's Caucus for Art, which is a national organization. It's one of the only national organizations that is devoted to promoting women in the arts. I was born in Boston, Massachusetts. I remember drawing from the time I was a little kid. I always had colored pencils in my hand. What was ever going on in the family, I was always busy drawing. I have a scene I still kind of love. I'd look out there in the winter and the snow and the bus would come around. I was right in the middle of the city area of Dorchester and the trolley and people waiting in the snow. And scenes out the windows of various rooms of my house at the time, the sun porch, my bedroom, the things that were in it. I did a lot of drawings of things in the house. In junior high, too, I was the drawer. I was doing all the artwork for everything. I guess, you know what, it was all I could do. It was what I did, is what I did best. I was the art editor of the high school yearbook. I did the end papers of the yearbook. I did anything that needed art, I did the art. And I couldn't do anything else. I didn't do that, I'd be a dead duck, I guess. It went from very early on. I mean, it was just, I loved it. That's what I had to do. Actually, when I graduated high school, through the Scholastic Art Awards, I did get a scholarship to the school of my choice, which was the Boston Museum School, which is next to the Museum of Fine Arts there on the Fenway. It was the place I'd been, it was my nirvana. And and I met David, and I didn't want to go back to Chicago and all the rest of it, come to the art. And I said, no, I've been waiting all my life for museum school, and I ain't giving it up. And we'll be married for a long time. We can wait a year. And actually, it was a very hard year, because he went to Chicago, and I stayed in Boston. And it was years of evolution, really. I did lots of drawing. We came to Chicago after I graduated museum school, and I did go to classes at the Art Institute, night classes. I was working actually at Marshall Fields. I got into display work, window display, which was great fun. And then after my babies were born, I put it aside for a bit because I felt I didn't want to be conflicted. So I was drawing. I was always drawing. So that became my main medium for a long time, was graphite, you might say, glorified word for pencil. Except pencil in many different shades, is soft and hard and different grades, and I kind of use it like a palette. You can paint with pencil in a sense. I don't mean smearing around, I mean different qualities of hardness over something very soft, or the soft over the hard. It gives you different textures and a variety of tonality, which is exciting. So I moved to pastel. So I'd have color, and that took a whole, that was a learning, because it's a whole different technique, whole different manner of work. The oil stick, you make strokes, you can brush into it and all that. Pastel is something else. It's more of a drawing medium, but you can smear and blend, and you can brush with it. You can do other things with it, a lot of things you can do with it. But it's different, and so I got into that. Right here is the artwork of my younger daughter, Shoshana. She is actually right now a book illustrator, and this was a self-portrait she did when she was in art school. Naomi, my older daughter, is in logistics now. She was a dancer from her early years on, and that probably has had maybe some effect on my interest in that area. Where I used to have a studio was at Noyes Cultural Arts Center in Evanston, and at that time there was a dance company, the Linda Martha Dance Company had their studios there and their classes, and they were wonderful. And actually they would let me go in there and sketch. I liked to, you know, do quick sketches of the dancers while they were practicing and all that. I loved it. At that time I was due to have a show at my gallery downtown, Dennis Rosenthal, J. Rosenthal Fine Arts. So I had all the stuff that he knew about, and then I had all these dancers there. And he looked around and he said, "Oh my God," he said, "this is the show. This is the show, and this is what you're going to show." I said, "What? I thought I was finished." No, this is it. So then I had to really scramble. I was hiring like day and night. I was going around the clock painting dancers. And so I got this big mass of work, and it was a great show. It was really fun. I really let go with those big paintings, big brush,
lot of drippage and stuff like that, but there's also a lot of linear stuff. That's the drawing part that still goes in there. And I vacillate. I go from doing that kind of thing to going back to the very traditional. I have always just loved to draw the human form, the face, all right, the expressiveness, but also hands. If you'll notice and you see my work, it's a lot of feet and a lot of hands. Try something with your hands. I've often thought about, like, what does this mean? You're looking at things and you take this object and you're reproducing it on a flat surface. Why? But there is something about the connection of the brush to the canvas, to the person or object you're painting. You're delineating it. I suppose it's a kind of identification with the object. I mean, when I was teaching, I told the students, you have to become what you're drawing. You have to become the object you're painting, whatever it is. You are it. And that's how you feel it. You feel it from its innermost core out. Change some of the color relationships, I think. And I love the feel of a brush. I can't explain it. I don't know what it is, but I just love it. And without it, it's like something very major missing in my life. I need it. It's like breath and air. It's just part of one's being. I want to get the white in there later. I really like that. And then just got some of that drawing. Now the truth is out. The Levinson family portrait, which only took me 9 years to complete, but that's one of the exigencies of life.
We were invited to the Roth house, and I had occasion to see the paintings that Judy had in the house, and I fell in love. I told my husband that this was a true artist, that I would love to have one of these works, and he surprised me for my birthday. He bought The Equestrian, which is in the living room. And I was just delighted, and I just made my purpose to keep on collecting Judy.
That more recent drawing, the pastel drawing of the seated dancer, the red hair, as I've worked through the years, I've become a little more abstracted in my approach. I've always been involved with negative space. That's been a very important part of my work. There's a conversation, there's an interaction, and what is left unsaid is sometimes as important as the part that you articulate and express. I've been a member of the American Jewish Artists Club since 1973. It was just before the Yom Kippur War, actually. And it was an amazing experience for me because I think they were the group that brought me out of myself. The painting war at Spertus, there are a lot of things going on in there, but it represents what happens in the course of a war. The woman depicted with the military hat is like a symbol of actually of a war-torn country to me. And I was thinking of a lot of things. I mean, it was Kuwait, it is right now, it is Israel. In a sense, being besieged from all around, from people, from terrorism. The figure, the woman, is vulnerability. It's the rape of a country. There's a lot of different emotions in there. Her scarf, it's fire, it's blood. The background is smoke, flame. I guess it's very emotional. I feel it very strongly. And it's not just female, it's male, female, it's all of us. Her hands, too, male, female. The stance, it's aggressive, but, you know, but there is this terrible vulnerability. But she's strong, and she'll survive.
I saw Judith Roth's work originally at the Chicago Artists Coalition exhibit downtown, and I was very taken with it. The color, the mood in it, the quality of the work. And I contacted Judith, and she was gracious enough to agree to bring some of her pieces to our gallery. And I have told people here that I feel that Judith is an artist. Artist, that anyone who is trained as an artist or has an art background
really appreciates the quality of the work that she produces.